Israel will never prevail over Iran. Iran is a real culture. Israel is not.
Israelis were relieved that President Trump emerged safe and sound from that dastardly attack on him, dastardly attack on American democracy. There is no room for political violence in democracies. I also want to thank President Trump.
They're going to call you a Nazi for that one. Yeah, because whenever people are like, whenever people point out that Israel has no culture except for like the borrowed bits of Jewish.
He's heard about the fact that like a lot of Israeli food, like hummus and some other bullshit like comes from Middle Eastern food or other Arab countries or some shit. And he's like, oh, they must have no culture because I heard these like two things.
For like the borrowed bits of Jewish culture that they get from all around the world, people call you, dude, that's not Israeli culture, that's Jewish culture. If it's culture that's just like cobbled together, whatever you get from like local Arab culture or like the Palestinian culture and or whatever you pull in from Brooklyn or New York or whatever, that's not the same as like a national culture. Jews are not Israel.
It's such an unfathomably stupid assertion. It's probably fair to say that I'm going to be honest. I have absolutely no fucking idea. What was the year that like Hinduism started or like Buddhism? I'm assuming Judaism is like older than both of these easily, right? Or do these like have their roots in some cringe? Well, hold on. Hinduism is more than 4,000 years old. Is Judaism 4,000 or 5,000? How old is Judaism? How old is Judaism? Nearly 4,000 years. It's about on par. I will say about the same. It's like one of the oldest religions in the world, with a lot of tradition and history tied back to like the religion itself. How can you say they have no history? How can you say they have no culture?
A national culture. Jews are not Israel. Israel's a Jewish state. Shut the fuck up with this bullshit. Israel is a state that claims to be Jewish and has a large Jewish population. There's no real any such thing. There's no innate transposition of an ethnic or religious identity to a state. A state is a legal entity, not a cultural identity. That's like ethno-state logic, okay? We say Israel is a Jewish.
Oh my God, it's just the most, I love it. I love it for him. I love it for him because he's so American and so white, and I value and I like that. I love that he can say that just without a second thought. I love that for him. Because you know what? For America, it is true. And I love that about our country. It's one of the things that makes America one of the best fucking countries on the planet. But whoa, that type of thinking does not necessarily apply to the rest of the world. Plenty of states, you know, are formed of nations of people that have a strong ethnic similarity to each other. And, you know, what ethnicity means and even what a nation of people means are all up for debate. But the idea that there's absolutely no linkage between any of these concepts is delusional. But the answer Google gives is wrong. They take the Bible literally. Judaism started about 2,800 years old, not 3,800 years. Okay.
No state logic, okay? We say Israel is a Jewish state as a kind of rhetorical shorthand. Like, yes, they have the Hebrew star in the flag. Yes, they ostensibly represent the interests of Jewish people, but we know they don't actually. They'll buy into the ethno-nationalism, man.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I understand it, too. The reason why he's doing this is because for lefties that are hypercritical of Israel, who don't want to be labeled as anti-Semitic, the easy shortcut out of that is you're to say, oh, well, Israel has nothing to do with Jewish people. So now you can be infinitely critical of the state without being critical of people. I'm guessing that's why it's like a shorthand escape for that. Cute. As a lefty, I was on board with everything he said, and then he said, you can't be separate Jews and the state of Israel. What? Why not? You 100% should. There are plenty of Jews who dislike Israel. I don't know what your comment means. The vast majority of Jews are pro-Israel existing, just as a heads up. Anybody that tells you differently is lying. It's like 90%, I think.
Are people in YouTube chat seriously arguing about the culture thing? You people are fucking insane. Culture is a completely nebulous, indeterminate term. You could argue a single household has a specific culture.
Oh, man. It's just a huge fallacy of just because it might be difficult to identify one thing from another doesn't mean that the other thing doesn't exist. Oh, actually, fuck. I think there's a quote from this book that actually addresses what he just said perfectly. Oh, I bet I didn't highlight this. It was in this part, though. I don't think I did.
Household has a specific culture. When I said Israel has no culture in that respect, what I mean is that Israel is a settler colonial state. It's a hastily slapped together mess of like local Arab influence, which they are continuously dispossessing and suppressing, along with dozens and dozens and dozens of expats and immigrants. Colonial state. It's a hastily slapped together mess of like local Arab influence, which they are continuously
He doesn't know anything. Hastily slapped together. There were organizations that were literally created to begin the painstaking brick by brick building of this country in a particular way, with a particular vision, with a particular coordinated plan. From what were the two? Let's see. What was it? I think one was called the Jewish Agency, and the other was called the one was for like managing land, and then the other I think was for managing money and immigration. I remember the two different ones. There were two huge ones. Herzl theorized them, and then they began in order to coordinate people like moving to the Middle East, Jews moving to the Middle East. They all learned Hebrew again, right? That was a dead language, by the way. They all learned Hebrew to bring themselves together. Herzl even thought it was a stupid idea. We're not going to fucking learn Hebrew again. What a retarded idea. And then like one dude managed to say, nah, we should. It'd be cool. And they're like, oh, fuck it. It would be cool. They all came with concepts of Western government. They all came from a similar religious background. They all, like, the idea that it was just this hodgepodge of random things. How do you think that could have survived in the Middle East? How could that have survived around an island? They were in an ocean of enemy states. What? Was it the Jewish National Fund? It might have been. I remember. There was two big initial organizations for, like, acquiring land, for getting money from Jewish people. And all the people that initially moved knew that it was going to suck shit. They even wrote about it. They're like, listen, the first Jews that come over, you guys might have been bankers. You guys might have been bankers. when you come over, you're going to be farmers, okay? You're going to work the land. You're going to work in these shifts every single day. You're going to irrigate. You're going to make crops. You're going to tend to the land. And that's what you're going to do. And the first 20 years are going to fucking suck, all right? The first and second waves of people that came over, the first and second aliyahs, failed fucking miserably. They suck shit. It wasn't until like the third or fourth, like I think in the 1880s up to like 1904, 1905 or something. It wasn't until like the next wave started coming that they had better funding. They're like, okay, fuck, maybe this is, yeah, we can try. Like this idea that it's like a hodgepodge of random shit is just so wrong. It's like ahistorical as fuck.
Slap together mess of like local Arab influence, which they are continuously dispossessing and suppressing, along with
it's also local Arab influence. When Israel came, they literally fashioned themselves as a Western style democracy. They saw themselves as better, as superior to like the local Arab style of governance, local Arab cultures. Like they came with like a Western democratic background in mind.
Dozens and dozens and dozens of expats and immigrants from all over the world. It's a colonial project.
Dozens and dozens of expats and immigrants. It's a diaspora. It's a diaspora. What are you talking about? What? It wasn't like a Russian and an American. What? What is that statement? Wait, what?
The culture of Israel is the culture of the homogenate that enter it, but it's not the same as having a regional culture that is based on like local trends that have developed over a long time. Those are distinct things. If you disagree, then you're kind of historically ignorant, man. That's just sort of how it works. Given enough time, Israel could form a distinct identity of its own, but right now its only real distinguishing identity is the one democracy in the Middle East, the Zionist ethnostate, you know? Colorism, white supremacy, and European settler colonial
colorism. Most of the Jews that are going to be in Israel now are going to be Jews from other Middle Eastern countries. Most of them are going to be colored people. White supremacy? You know that white supremacists don't consider Jewish people to be white, right? You know that that's not the that's not the even comedians know this.
When me and Brad first think we can come to an understanding. Technically, I don't consider Jewish people white.
Neither do I.
Like,
you know, colorism, white supremacy, and European settler colonial ethnic supremacy are all like key components of cultural development there. But when you ask things like, okay, what is Israeli architecture like? What is Israeli food like? You're not going to get many strong answers, because in a lot of cases, they're just cobbled together answers from the basic bits and pieces of the area that was there before and from the people that have come over. That's just what happens when you're new there.
I can't watch the rest of this. What is Israeli architecture like? You're never going to get an answer to that. You understand that a lot of the religious monuments there that were built before Islam even existed as a fucking religion, right? What kind of a question is that? What is Israeli, like, Israeli, well, no, not even, because Kingdom of Israel, like, it's such an unbelievably stupid, He just doesn't know anything. That's okay. I don't care. I don't know why I'm watching this. Okay. I don't know why the fuck I'm watching this. It's okay. Okay.
Love it on IV, bro. Hype. Mustard on the beat, ho. Bebo, penny rap, nickel, yeah, free throw. Man, damn, call out Amber Lambs. Tell him, breathe, bro. Nella nigga to the cross, he walk around like Tizo. What's up with these jabroni ass niggas trying to see Compton? The industry can hate me. Fuck them all in the mama.